Members of a small Tongan church in South Auckland are being targeted by an elaborate passport scam promising residency for cash. One News understands hundreds of overstayers have been caught up in the scheme so far, which is being led by trusted members of the Pacific community. Pacific correspondent Barbara Drever has this exclusive report.
Reverend Tevita Piper Vave isn't keen to discuss details of a passport scam involving his small Mangere church.
I mean, we did want to know what you've done with the passports and the money that you've taken from overstayers.
I'm going to talk to you when I'm available.
At least three meetings have been held here at his home after church services. One News was outside one of them, where overstayers and others wanting residency are lured in by big promises. Claims that if they pay up to $800 cash, they'll get permanent residency.
We will definitely get it when we will pay the $500. They said that our permanent resident visa will be attached. Will be printed out on our passport.
Witnesses claim another man involved told them Prime Minister Jacinda Ardern appointed him a licensed immigration agent. They say they were promised when they paid up they'd go on a road trip, first to Tauranga later this month to see land allegedly bought by the church, then on to Wellington for more meetings before heading to the Bay of Islands in the lead up to Waitangi Day, then back to Auckland for a night at Sky City Hotel where a High Court judge would supposedly sign off their residency. They'd receive it by the end of February.
In the last 48 hours, I've found out in excess of about 100 people who have paid money, ranging from $500 each to $800 per family.
Including family members, that's potentially several hundred people affected. And the story told to the victims is elaborate. The first 10 families to pay up promised a free home to be provided by government. And then there's the plane.
The church will be having a plane and they were running a flight airline, and the people of the church, they will first hop into the plane and they will go straight to Tonga, and they will spend there 2 weeks.
While this scenario sounds too good to be true, for Tongans, being told this in a place of worship, backed by their minister or Whaifekau, adds extra credibility.
When you talk about Whaifekau, they held a lot of power. In our community. And when a Whaifekau say things like this, people bound to believe and they'll do it.
Community leaders are furious. Their most vulnerable have been targeted yet again. One News exposed a similar scam back in 2012, which ended in prosecutions.
It's a concern to me to make sure that our Pasifika whānau is aware that these scammers or these sharks walking around trying to gain money off them.
And an emotional plea to his people to beware the scam.
We want to know why your church is involved in this illegal scheme.
I don't want to talk to you about what you say, illegal. It is
illegal. It is illegal. Absolutely illegal.
Illegal. Yep. So I'm going to give you a ring.
That talk hasn't happened and questions remain unanswered.
Yes, indeed. It's clear there are a lot of unanswered questions here. Barb is with me now. And Barb, what is Immigration New Zealand saying about this?
Well, after we contacted them, they have told us that the Immigration Advisors Authority will be doing the initial investigation. And they're really keen to hear from anyone who feels that they're a victim or may know someone. Of course, Wendy, this is extremely problematic because overstayers are here illegally and they're really keen to stay out of sight of authorities. But it is important. This needs to be exposed.
And you've been speaking to a number of those targeted. What are they saying to you? How are they feeling?
Well, some unfortunately do feel that this is a legitimate scheme, but this absolutely is not. There is no High Court judge there who is going to sign off residency. This is not the case. It is just not going to happen. But for those who do realise that this is not going to happen for them and they've paid across money, they're absolutely devastated and very angry that they've been targeted by people who they trusted.
I can just imagine. Thank you, Barbara, and no doubt more to come on this story from you. Thanks, Pacific correspondent Barbara Drever with that exclusive report.